Hello everyone, Rabbi Rosen here, hoping all is well with you, with a thought for Shabbat. This evening begins the observance of the 20th yahrzeit of my father, William Rosen, of blessed memory, and of course it's an occasion for remembering what made him the kind of remarkable man that he was. One of the things that was so important about him was that he had a very limited formal education, but was a voracious reader throughout his life, especially when it came to history. I once asked him, "Dad, why do you love history so much?" And he answered very simply, "You have no idea where you're going until you know where you've been." It's a sentiment that I think rings very powerfully for all of us, and especially when it comes to a Torah portion such as ours. Key to the portion is the idea of transition. Moses makes certain that when he departs from the stage of history, the people will have a leader so that the flock will not be like a group of wandering sheep without a shepherd. That is crucial to him. We also are given not only the kind of begets, the kind of genealogies of that which has taken place in the past, we also see an arrow pointed forward into the future. Holidays, sacred times, moments where we will come together throughout the entire calendar year on the high holidays and this festival of Sukkot and Pesach and Shavuot, all of these times that we might be able to celebrate what it means to be together, to celebrate God's presence, an arrow pointing, future-oriented celebrations. The great writer Isaac Bashevis Singer says that what we need most in life is not only a memory of the past, but also a memory of the future. So let's do what Isaac Bashevis Singer, and in a different way, my father suggested counts in life. Let's remember the past, let's celebrate who we are, and let's find ways of cherishing our future, something that we build one day at a time, inviting the sacred, the important, and the precious into our lives. Shabbat Shalom.